six outstanding and diverse tunes by diverse composers, and I hope that you guys will enjoy. This will be the last, one of the last times you hear me talk tonight. I've had six of our students who are going on next year to be music majors in college have prepared a little something to say about each one of the pieces. So tonight, we're going to start with Patrick Fanfare, and Alyssa's going to tell you a little bit about that.
Thank you. pageant is a more contemporary piece written in 1953 by Vincent Crispin. When thinking about works at this time, it is important to recognize that the 50s were a strange decade. With the end of World War II, the United States was brought to a future of grief, moral uncertainty, and a somewhat newfound fear of imminent destruction. This led to an expansive exploration of the arts, trying to express new experiences and answer burning questions. But from Jackson Pollock to Louis D. Hardin, art got weird, and this is where pageant came in. To me, pageant really scales all of these large and existential things down to the level of the average person. According to UNC Charlotte, pageant was originally titled Morning Music Band. And when you listen to it, it's not surprising. This piece opens with a beautiful woodwind centered melody that rises in intensity until disrupted by the chaos of the photograph. This pattern often repeats itself throughout a common trend in contemporary music of this era. The opening woodwind feature could be akin to a gentle sunrise in a slow morning, abruptly disrupted by the various chaotic and eventually gentle moments of the day. Have a good
Thank you.
also wanted the piece, throughout the piece, you should listen for what people could have been, what they should have achieved, and what we miss. So hope for the hymn is to help people that are grieving, for loved ones. Even though the feeling of despair never goes away, music can help process it.
Yeah.
of music. I think it's such a powerful meaning behind it. And I think it's true to Julie Drew's words, that really can help in the process. That middle section, where just all of a sudden out of nowhere, that pang of feeling hits you, I think is so true to life. So I hope you guys enjoy that. I hope you enjoy the two pieces prior to that. We're going to shift gears wholly now to a little different thing. I'll tell you about that in a second. But we had two students who 4 years ago did a thing at their final 8th grade spring concert, and they wanted to run it back real quick. And so they're going to come sit and work back at their entrance.
Click the slide. Worked earlier. There it goes.
Closeness being weakness and individuality.
chose to play this piece.
This next piece is one I had the pleasure of performing all the way back in 2019 at the FSU Summer Music Camp, and I've been beginning to play it for the past 2 years again. It begins with an epic French horn entrance, shifting the song to gear, continuing on to musical rhythms within the brass, while moving between time signatures, chromatic runs throughout the woodwinds, and percussion parts that will keep them and the audience paying attention. Until the Scars by John Mackey, who is my favorite composer, as I have stated, told Mr. Odom and most of the band, is a symphonic band adaptation of the first movement of Hubris from Blind Dark City Symphony for Band. This song is based off of Homer's ancient story of the Odyssey. For those of you not familiar with the Odyssey, it is about Odysseus' return home after defeating the Trojans in the Trojan War. This piece encompasses the dangers he faced on his return, whether it be the taunting sirens, the Cyclops, and one of the most arduous territories he has ever crossed, the land of the dead. Odysseus was able to fight his way back home after a decade-long travel. He lost himself in this pursuit, only to find it again when returning home. He grew and evolved as a character to be the best version of himself. Throughout the evolution of the piece you're about to hear, what is distinct between where you are in Odysseus' travels and in the song itself. I hope you guys are able to enjoy listening to this piece as much as we have.
Thank you. Our next tune is not one, but two selections from the hit film How to Train Your Dragon. The music for How to Train Your Dragon was written by the legendary film score composer John Powell. This movie was actually Powell's first solo movie score composition, and probably his most well-known one, with multiple awards being won. Those being Best Original Score for an Animated Film in 2011, as well as Best Film Score of the Year in 2011. In an interview with Polygon, Powell stated that while composing for How to Train Your Dragon was difficult, it was very comfortable for him. Growing up in a Scottish family with an abundance of Celtic music, he felt at home. While listening, you will hear some of those Celtic influences. We'll start off by playing This Is Bird, which starts soft and calm, capturing the serenity of the village, then becomes intense and violent when the dragons begin to wreak havoc and are at war with the Vikings. After that, we will play Coming Back Around, which contrasts our first song in the sense that humans and dragons are no longer at war with each other, but living in harmony together. We hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Got one more song for you. I figure I might as well say a couple of things. One, again, thank you for being here today. Two, you may have noticed on your way in that there was some artwork out in the lobby, and that is a collaboration we have with the AP art class. They listen to, they describe, and they researched a little bit of those pieces and made some artwork from the pieces that you've heard tonight. So if you missed them on the way in, on your way out, make sure you check them out, because there's some really spectacular stuff out there that is, I think, meaningful. And it's just the first collaboration we've had, but I hope it's not the last one we have for us. Secondly, that piece you just heard was supposed to have been on the seniors' freshman year's spring concert as well, which is why we decided to play tonight, but you, of course, know what happened. That was going to be a heck of a spring concert. So I hope that's a little something to appreciate. We're going to close the song with another dedication to the senior class. I didn't think it was going to make a joke. I've affectionately dubbed this their Rio class song. This is an entry of the Gladiators, and Bridget's going to tell you a little bit more about it.
This song, Entry of the Gladiators, was not originally intended as a service march. It was initially written in 1897 by Czech composer Julius Fischer, and was entitled Grand March of Remedy. It was composed to showcase dramatic rhetoric because of the new innovations in brass instrument technology that allowed fast chromatic gears in all brass instruments. However, he changed the name of the march after being so impressed by the description of the gladiators in the novel Proteus. It wasn't known as the circus march we know today until Carl Fischer published an adaptation for American Wind Bands by Louis-Philippe de Rondeau called Thunder and Blazes. It has been used and known for since then for its use in circuses and often to introduce class. I think this piece really sums up our high school experience. Isn't it good?